Hi, Wick. Welcome to the Y-Lock second grade worksheet, lesson 10. So to begin, we're using logical reasoning. So it says, circle the statements that equal the number at the top. Cross out the wrong statements and correct them. So let's see here. 5 plus 5, it equals 10, right? And 7 plus 3 equals 10, right? This one, 9 plus 0. What is 0? 0 is nothing, right? So 9 plus 0 is 9 plus nothing, which means that it's just 9. So this does not equal 10. It has to be 1 plus 9. And 4 plus 7, what does that equal? Well, we saw here that 7 plus 3 is 10, right? 4 is 1 more than 3. So then if you add 1 more to 10, it becomes 11, right? So this is 11, which means that it does not equal 10. So it has to be changed to, let's make it 4 plus 6. This one can also be 0 plus 10. And of course, this one can also be 3 plus 7. Let's see the last one, 2 plus 8. This is equal to 10, right? So then we're supposed to circle it. So do the same things for same thing for the rest of these problems, and let's go on to the next part. Addition or subtraction. Write plus or minus to make the statement true. So let's see. 12. Is it plus 7 to equal 5 or minus 7? Well, 12 is bigger than 5, right? So in order to make this number smaller, make smaller, you have to have a subtraction equation. So in this, it would be 7 minus, sorry, 12 minus 7 equals 5. And let's see here. Next, number 2. So what's this relationship? Well, 4 and 12, 4, 12 is bigger than 4, right? So we have to make it larger. So if we have to make it larger, it's an addition equation, right? So 4 plus 8 equals 12. Let's do one more. 7 and 10. 10 is larger than 7, so we have to make it larger. In order to make it larger, that's a plus equation. Plus, and making it smaller is a minus equation. 7 plus 3 equals 10. Right, so do the rest of these problems and let's move on. Addition and subtraction. Mark the correct answer. Okay, so when you do your work, show your work on this side. And then on this side, just on this side, they just want your answer. Just answer, okay? So let's see. Which is a way to show 11? So let's try each one of these. 10 minus 1. If you count backwards from 10, one time, it's 9, right? So this does not equal 11. Let's try 4 plus 1. Plus 3. 4 plus 1 is 1 more than 4, right? So this is 5. Plus 3. What is that? 5, and then add 3. 6, 7, 8. So this equals 8, which does not equal 11. So that doesn't equal 11 either. So let's try 8 plus 3 plus 1. 8 plus 3 is 8, and then 1, 2, 3. So 8, 9, 10, 11. And then add 1, 12. So this equals 12, which does not equal 11. So ready by, what's the method called? Not trial and well, this is trial and this case is trial and error since we're trying every problem. But through process of elimination, we can already tell that this one has to be the right one, right? But let's check it out anyway. 7 plus 6. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And then minus 2. So 13 minus 2 equals 11, which equals 11. So that checks out. That's why it's this last option. Let's go on to the last page. Word problems. Addison and Albert have 16 marbles in all. Addison has 7 marbles. How many marbles does Albert have? So if Albert and Addison make up to 16 marbles and Addison has 7, that means Albert's, which is the number of marbles we don't know, plus 7, which is Addison's marbles, equals 16. So that means it's 16 equals 7 plus the number, right? So let's, if we rewrite the equation, we can find what this number is by subtracting it from this side. So minus 7 equals the number. 16 minus 7 is? So 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. So it equals 9, right? So Albert has 9 marbles. And let's try this next one because it's kind of confusing. Albert gave some marbles to Addison. Addison now has 12 marbles. How many marbles did Albert give Addison? So it's a two-part equation. Now Addison has 12, right? So we set up this equation in the same way. 12 plus this number equals 16. And we move this to this side. 16 minus 12 equals the number. And then if you subtract 12 from 16, well, we could cancel out the 1 since they're both 10, worth 10. We get 6 minus 2, so 6, 5, 4. 6 minus 2 equals 4. So Albert has 4 marbles, but we're not there yet. We're not done yet. We have to find how many mar- Oh, actually, I just realized, sorry. That's not what it's asking. Addison has 12 marbles, right? And how many marbles did Albert give her? So it's 7 plus the amount of marbles that he gave her, right? Because she started with 7. So then we rewrite this equation. 12 minus 7 equals the number. And if we count backwards from 12, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 5 marbles. So he gave 5 marbles. So try the rest on your own, and I hope to see you guys next week.